I would love to go back to the day I set up my first saltwater aquarium. And if I could, this video is the advice I'd give to myself, because 90% of new saltwater hobbyists leave the hobby after just 1 year. But there are three things the top 10% do to avoid failure. So in this video, I'll tell you what those three things are, so you can give yourself the best possible chance for success. Now, when you're new to the hobby, you probably think of a reef tank as keeping fish and coral, but the better approach is to think of it as keeping water. Fish and corals get almost everything they need from the water they live in, from oxygen to nutrients to elements like calcium they use to build their skeletons. So providing great quality water is important to give your wet pets the perfect environment in which to thrive. And because fish and corals live and breathe in your water, they also suffer if your water quality is off base. And letting water quality slip is the most common cause of problems in a saltwater aquarium. All of which means you'll be ahead of the game by just using good quality source water. Now, the easiest place to start is your local fish shop, which will almost certainly sell pre-mixed saltwater. But not all shops maintain the same standards, so to check their water quality is up to scratch, ask what TDS your shop keeps their water at. TDS is total dissolved solids, i.e. stuff in the water other than pure H2O. So 0 TDS is the ideal number, but while anything under 10 is probably okay, if the number is above 10, you should look elsewhere. But while buying salt water is the easiest option, if you want the best option, you should filter your own water. To do so, you'll need an RODI filter. Now, these things look intimidating, but the reality is that once you've bought one, you'll wonder why you were ever worried about it. It's just a series of 4 or 5 different filters connected together by a bit of tubing. It runs off your home water pressure, so there are no moving parts. You just open the in and out taps to start filtering and close them when your container is full. And if you don't want to plummet into your home water pipes, you can even get a tap attachment that screws onto your kitchen or bathroom taps, so you can connect and disconnect it once a week when you need water. Now, working out which RODI filter you should buy can be a bit of a minefield. So if you don't want to add to your research burden, I'd recommend the 4-stage Waterbox RODI filter as a great starter. It's designed specifically for reef tanks and it has everything you need to get started. And if you want a cheaper alternative, my choice is this unit from Vyair, which is the little brother of the filter I personally use for all my tanks. If you can stretch your budget, get the unit with the optional booster pump. RODI filters produce clean water very slowly, and the booster pump will double or triple the speed and make the filter run much more efficiently. And while chilling out north of 100 notes on a water filter might seem steep at the outset, it'll pay for itself in less than 3 months, as you'll save a fortune over buying water from your local fish shop. And more importantly, it will give you control over your water quality, which, as I say, is the single most important thing to get right. So now you've laid the foundations for great water quality, you have won half the battle. The other half is keeping your water pristine. And the key to that is testing. We humans are simple creatures and we tend to think that seeing is believing. But when it comes to water, seeing means next to nothing. Take the River Thames in London, for example. The water looks filthy and most people wouldn't flush their toilet with that stuff. But the truth is that the Thames is actually rated as one of the cleanest rivers in the world and is host to a wide range of marine wildlife, including seahorses. True story. And with a saltwater tank, you'll want to test the main parameters once a week. For the first 3 months, that means testing salinity, nitrate and phosphate, which should take a total of 10 to 15 minutes. Then when you want to get your first coral, add calcium, alkalinity and magnesium to that list, which will add another 10 to 15 minutes a week. By simply testing those parameters once a week, it will keep you ahead of the game, as you'll be able to spot when your water parameters start to drift out of whack and take actions to bring things back in line. It is, of course, much easier to prevent a problem from happening in the first place than it is to fix it after the fact, especially when you don't know what your water parameters have been up to. And the third thing you need to do to put yourself in the top 10% is water changes. One of the most searched phrases in our hobby is how to run a tank without water changes. And I get it, there's no two ways about it. Mixing up your own salt water every single week, then removing old tank water and replacing it with new water is a pain in the cock. Now, for the first few months when you're still in the honeymoon period, you'll keep it up no problem. But after that, you'll miss one or two here and there. Then before you know it, you've not done a water change for a month. And you'll say to yourself, my tank has never looked better. At which point you'll decide that water changes are just a marketing scheme to sell salt mix. And you'll find yourself searching for how to run a reef tank without water changes. And when you do, you'll probably stumble across some great tanks that don't do water changes. You might even discover Triton Method, a whole system that's based on the principle of avoiding water changes to create a thriving, stable ecosystem. And to be honest with you, it can be done, and Triton Method does produce some exceptional tanks. But the trade-off is that Triton Method involves sending water samples to a lab regularly and constantly adding a few milliliters of one of the 20 bottles they'll sell you for £20 a bottle. And guess what the Triton lab results will recommend you do if your water parameters are out of whack? Water changes. Seriously. Changes happen slowly in a reef tank, and 6 months after you've stopped doing water changes, when your corals are fading and your rock is covered in algae, you'll be racking your brains trying to work out what you've done in the past week that could have caused all this. When the real answer is that your problems are as a result of a slow build-up over several months that would have been kept in check with weekly water changes. And it's at this point you'll realise that the successful tanks you saw that don't run water changes are successful despite that, and not because of it. Because fixing problems in a reef tank is much more hassle than preventing them, don't think of water changes as a chore, think of them as investing time to keep your tank in the top 10%. Now, when you clicked on this video, you might have been expecting some guidance on what kind of wave makers to buy or what brand of LED lights will make your corals grow the fastest. But the reality is that most equipment available in the hobby is actually really good these days, and your choice of equipment will have a minimal impact on how successful you are. Instead, it's focusing on water quality that will put you in the top 10% of hobbyists. So if that sounds like your cup of tea, watch this video next as you're ready to take the next step.